and I'm turning over control. And there we go. And we should be starting here in just a moment.
Okay, thank you, Steve. So let me share my screen. Sorry, 1 second. Oops. Okay. Can you see my slides?
Yes, Juji.
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah, so today I'm gonna talk about how to handle user-free text responses using Juji. I'm very happy to talk about this topic because I think this is where Juji's power is at. And we do have a lot of features to help our chatbot owner to handle user-free text responses. So let's start. So why do we care about free text responses? The reason is simple. Compared to conventional choice questions, free text response provide the designer, the business with more information. Also, the information is more accurate. Since inside the choice question, your options are fixed, and in a free text response, even though the answer might be close to the option, but there might be subtle differences. And you can see unique answers from different users. And the free text response also allows unlimited cases. Basically, user can write whatever they want. Another benefit is it promotes more interaction between the chatbot and the user. We found that user tend to ask more questions and also try to clarify the question more. And this in turn will also provide more information when we use the free text responses. However, all this benefit comes with challenges. So one of the main challenges is to cover all cases. So one variation in the user response is that user can use different things to mean the same. And then user might have questions on the current topic. For example, you asked about favorite food and user might say, why do you want to ask this? And moreover, the users might have other digressions in conversation. If you are a restaurant, no matter what you are asking, the user might say, okay, so where are you located? And even if inside the context of your question, user might not say something you expected. So basically some unexpected question responses and sometimes typos also make your chatbot to miss some information. So at Juji, we rarely care about how the free text responses are handled. And we are also very proud of that. We actually encourage our users to add more free text questions, open-ended questions to collect more information from their users. So there are two sides of the solution. So one is Juji provides AI-powered buildings. What kind of building we provide? So one is the chatbot template. Basically, the first thing you're gonna choose when you're creating a new new chatbot, you either choose a blank template or we provide almost 30 templates for your use cases. And another building is the conversation responses. Given the question you are asking, we have different responses, topic that's already covered a lot of digressions, you can choose one. And fallback handling, also spelling checkers. So on the other side, you can add your chatbot designer can add personal touches on the handling of user free text response. So we have AI powered customizations, including Q&As, default user input handling. This is a subtle one, we will talk more. And custom response. This is also very powerful to handle in context user response. So this is another view of the same features, because we can separate them using the context. So one side is out of context, which means doesn't matter where the user is asking the question or giving this interruption or unexpected response, we will try to handle if the condition is met. On the other side, in context, which means the handling only happen to the current topic context. And you can see that both our building and the customization is touching the both sides of this equation. And so let's dive in into the details of our buildings first. So the first thing you will see, as we mentioned, when you are creating a new chatbot is the template. We usually recommend our user, especially the new users, to use our template because the template provides building chat flow. So it has already populated topics inside, which is related to the use case you choose. Also Q&As. For example, if you choose customer service, the Q&As, you might already have Q&As regarding the say hours of your service and the location. So you can save some time to generate new questions and you can simply update the answer if needed. We also have building on the conversation response. We also encourage people to take advantage of this. Basically, when you create a new question, a new request, after you change the label of the question, Juji will try to automatically match a relevant response topic for you. For example, if your question is what's your favorite color, Juji will recognize this asking about favorite things, so we give you this topic. However, you can also go to the customized chatbot response section to choose some other building topics. And you can ping it if you don't want the topic to be changed again once you change your label. And the one thing to note is sometimes the designer are looking for more flexibility. For example, if researchers want to have full control, you are free to choose this ask a general question topic. This is a blank response topic, so you will have no condition there. Yeah, another building is the fallback handle. By default, they are turned on automatically when you create the chatbot. However, you can go there, go to the chatbot settings and uncheck the ones you don't like. So usually we will leave it for most cases because the fallback handling we provide are very general. It's for something like excuse in answering your question or user trying to skip the question, but you are free to uncheck them. We also have a beta version of spelling checker, which is powerful to auto-correct typos in common English words. Be careful though if you are expecting some other language or some special words, acronyms. If you have those expected, you might want to add this in an exclusion. By default, the spelling checker is turned off. Okay, so let's look at the customization part. So one important and powerful one is the Q&As. The Q&As basically is your customization of the fallback. Once you add your question there, doesn't matter where the user are, if they ask the question or similar questions, your Q&A will be triggered and provide the answer. And yeah, and you can see it, you can use the Q&A to override our built-in fallback. I believe we already have more than a couple webinars on Q&A, so feel free to watch those webinars because our Q&A is very powerful. There are a lot of functionalities there. This is a subtle one, the default user input handling. What it does is, for example, if you have your Q&A, you have the built-in fallback, somehow users' questions didn't match none of those. And then, so what happened? Juji provides a default response. It's similar to that, I'm not sure what to say, but with a lot of variations. However, if you want, you can customize your own response as default. Because even though the chatbot didn't have answer for that, it's powerful enough to recognize this is a request from the user. So your customization will show up when the user gives an unexpected fallback. Another thing you can do is to turn on this email notification opt-in. What it does is when the user asks an unanswered question, the chatbot will try to politely ask if they want to get email if the question is answered. And if the user is subscribed in, when you, as a designer of the chatbot, you have the monitors on your Q&A. So you will see an answer Q&A. And then if you answer the question, the user who subscribed will receive an email. This is very helpful for, say, customer service or education online programs. Yeah, last but not least is our powerful custom response customization. For each topic, each free text request topic, you are able to add custom response clicking. If you click on this plus custom response button, and you will see you the trigger and action pair, and you fill in the trigger and action. So let's look at the triggers first. So here are a list of all the triggers you can use. And they are put in three groups. So I group them by color. The first four is group one. So inside this group, you can actually select multiple conditions in the same trigger. Okay, so let's look at each trigger condition. So one is similar to, so this condition basically checks this semantic similarity between the user response and the sentences you put inside. The contains keywords is the chatbot will check if the one of the given keywords is used in your user response. Also, the keywords are nematized, which means, for example, you put keywords walk, and if the user response contains walk or walking or walks walked, those will still match your condition. Another condition is contains sentiment. So it checks if the select sentiment is present in your in the user responses. The matches condition is the advanced condition. It's the most flexible and powerful one. However, it does require you to use this wrap language pattern. So yeah, if you want to use it, please check our the documentation page I provide here to see what the pattern syntax is. And the default input, basically, it means none of other triggers match, then the default input will be put in. And is answered. Is answered, this is a bit different from other conditions. So is answered usually work with follow-ups. It's like a precondition in the follow-ups. So if the question is answered, the follow-up will be triggered. Usually the answer from the user are considered answered for the question. However, when the user skips the question, or sometimes the question is not asked at all due to your chat flow design, for example, you branch out to a different branch in your chat flow, then the question is considered not answered. So here are lists of actions you can use for your when the trigger matches. Not all actions are available, depends on the trigger you have. So the first action is quick acknowledgement. This is very simple. Just give a simple reply. Extend reply is a more powerful version of quick acknowledgement. Basically, you will use a message topic to give your reply. In that case, you can use web media, personalized messages with videos, all kind of stuff. The follow-up request is similar to extend reply, except it uses the request topic to ask a question as follow-up for the current topic. Moreover, you can have advanced actions. This include end chat, repeat current topic, and jump to topic. Repeat current topic is useful when you are handling some user in context digression and you want to ask the question again. And we will show you a couple examples. And the jump to topics is basically you will when this triggers, your chatbot will continue the conversation at the topic you choose. This is helpful if you want to skip a couple topics, or if you want to go back to a topic you have already passed. Okay, so I'm gonna show you a demo. Actually, I will cover all the features that I just talked about. So yeah, if you have any questions, you can leave in the chat message and I will cover them after my demo here. So let me go to our website. Okay. You can see my website, right?
Yes, we did great.
Okay, so I'm gonna create a new topic. New chatbot. So I'm gonna select a template. Let's say I choose the program general this one. So you see, once you select template, it has already populates some topic for you, which is related to your use case. And you see this one have already populated a lot of Q&As. For example, it is about education, online education programs. So it has admission, program info. And then you will be able to say if you want to change the response to update. Okay, so let's say I want to add a new topic. Say what's your favorite food? And once I put in my question, you see the label get automatically updated. And here you see the Juji platform already guessed what topic this is about. So it will put you a response topic. However, we can change this. So clicking this will see what kind of question they are. For example, if you are collecting some numbers, putting numbers here, you'll see phone numbers, some of them actually capture attributes for you. And then you can use this attribute later on your other topics. So it's very helpful if you are collecting some attributes, you choose the right building response topic. However, if you don't want anything, so you can go say, okay, I think I have to ask general questions. So this guy here, this have nothing. So you will see, if I choose this, I go to preview. And I say, I don't. So this is a blank response topic. So it simply acknowledges your answer and do nothing and pass on to the next question or topic. Instead, let's see what happens if we change to say a favorite. And again, you can ping this here. Once you ping, when you change your topic label, you will not, the topic will stay the same. So let's go. Let's say, I don't have any favorite. Okay, see, the building topic recognizes that you are giving a digression, and so it would politely ask something else. And let's say if I put something unexpected, for example, I put right here. So this is something unexpected. So it will just simply acknowledge my favorite for electricity. And I will show you how you can change this in context default. Let's just take a look at the building part. So we want to take a look at the fallbacks. So fallbacks you can find in the chatbot settings. They are here. You see we have a lot of fallbacks. And right now they are all selected. So let's see what happens if I say I want to I'm gonna skip this question. See, sorry, I cannot skip this question because it's required. Actually, it is required if you look at the section here. It's I make it required. However, I can change the response. Say, I don't want this anymore. See what happened. So this, I think this is a skip, right? So I just unselect this guy here and go to preview. Let's say, okay, see this is the default handling of, because the Juji, even though the building we turned off is not recognizing, it doesn't have answer for this, but it recognizes this as a request as in a fallback, so it will give you a default one. And actually, I can change this if I go to the default, for example, here. So I say something like I will pass. And optionally, you can also turn on this. This will politely ask for a email notification if the user wants to subscribe. Okay, see what it does. See, your default customization is used. And again, here it's asking for your email to give. So you can skip or you can give the email, say, okay, so if it's in real production, you will see this in your monitor dashboard here that you have answered question. And when you answer this question, the subscribe user will get the answer notification. I think, what else you want to check? The spelling checker. So let's turn on the spelling checker. So it's here. So you can simply turn it on and you are free to add some exclusions. And it's useful when you're expecting your user to put a lot of typos. So let's say what, this is a very common typo. What's your name? See, the spell checker at work, you change your user response question to the correct one and answer the question. And Q&A board. Q&A board here, I'm not gonna talk too much about, but I'm just gonna show you. You can use this to customize the fallback. So let's say, So there's something like this. Again, the bots are more. Okay, see, the previously was actually the building fallback to answer, but here it gave you the Q&A, you override the fallback, the building fallback. So, okay, so now let's go into the in-context response customization, which is also very useful. So see what we want to use. So basically you click this custom response. You see you get a pair of trigger and actions. So the trigger, as we saw before, have all kinds of triggers. Let's say this similar to, this is useful if you want to have some, you don't know exactly what the user is gonna say, but you know, it might say something along the line with seafood, with, even like fruits. So let's say I put I like fish, I like shrimp. Okay, so, and this percentile here is basically how similar you think the user response should be with your input. This is useful. Especially if you want to categorize. So let me show you what you can do. For example, now. That's the one, let's try it again. Okay.
When you get a next moment, I have a couple questions for you. Just let me know when you would like.
Okay. So let me finish this this part very quick. I like seafood. Actually, this is not in our list of sentences. But you see, it matches because the semantic is similar. So, but you can always, if you don't want that to happen too much, you can increase this. So which means you have to be really similar. It's like, okay, so now it actually goes to the default. Okay, so Steve, do you have some questions?
Yes, this is from Henry.
Okay.
Date open dash text input handling. ? Like, can I do next Monday, etc.? And then next, the in quotes, my profile data input handling ? Like, use my cell number to text me. What about a response generation to an open text input based on the user personality trait and some attributes collected for context? What about forward certain attributes collected to another person outside of the user? Sorry, bit out of topic of open text input and response.
Okay,
so Henry, if you want to clarify any of that, you can unmute yourself and just ask if you need further clarification, Wendy. So maybe take on the date open text input handling first. Can I do next Monday thing?
Date open text, like, can I do next Monday?
Do you want me to give you kind of like
expand a little bit more?
A use case?
Yeah.
So let's say if I am working on a bot that helps schedule somebody.
Yeah.
And the user to the bot said, let's say the bot said, I can schedule you on Friday, date at 10 o'clock. Yeah. And the user would say, nah, I'm busy, but how about next Monday?
Okay. So So there's two things you can do. One, to use say one of our building topics. So we have a topic for reservation, for example. So you see a reservation. Well, what is the reservation? Okay, yeah, actually here. So you see a reservation will collect all kind of data for you, and you will ask the data if it's missing, and inside you can also collect them.
Yeah, my question is, it's not that the you say, you know, can you tell me what day, what time, date, things like that. But the user wants the bot to figure out the date itself.
Oh.
So it's kind of like, I think maybe what I could do is create my own date function.
Yeah, so yeah, if you just want the date from given a week date, that, yeah, so we don't have a function, but it's easy, very easy to add. We can add if there's a use case. Also depends how you use it, because some API might be able to take the date directly to give you the, I mean, take the weekday directly. To give
you. Maybe I'll make a call to a service somewhere out there and say, what is 2 weeks from now, Monday?
Yes.
Give me the date back.
Yeah, you can do that. Or if you have a scheduler, for example, if a scheduler, then the scheduler might be already taking that into account.
Okay, so just don't handle the philosophy here is don't try to handle it by writing your own function. Find an external function and make an action call.
Yeah, in this case, it's because you will need to put this as schedule as well. So, yeah, I mean, if you have a schedule to handle that, that's the best thing to do.
But find a JavaScript library somewhere that has that sort of thing.
Or API calls, yeah.
Yeah, an API call. Yeah, they have an API call that can do that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So,
I think I'm good with that. The second question that I have is basically, this is recalling the profile data that the bot may already have on me. And then, so when the customer give an open text, like use my cell number to text me, I understand use my substitute cell number by a real number to text. And so the action is, okay, I'm going to create an SMS text for that particular reply.
Okay, yeah. So this is a more advanced usage. So we do support some of them, but mostly in building, like if you want using, say you're customized, if you want to customize this, you will need to customize specifically right now.
Okay, this sounds like I may need some tutorial from you how to do this.
Yeah, so for example, if it's in context, and actually it doesn't matter if it's in context or out context. So for example, you can have something like, click here, use my cell number. And in the response, you will do something. There's two things you can do. So one is to call a function to send the text message or API call. But because you already have the cell number, right?
Yeah, you have pulled it up somewhere and then stored in an attribute.
So it will be an attribute. So you're just putting that cell number attribute value to your function or API call. Another thing you can do is to use the extended reply to do more fancy stuff, which with the same, you will use a function or a post action. Post action is in here for, so all the topic has post action, you can do functions or API call layer. Yeah, so basically the number is already in the attribute, so you can use the attribute when you think it's appropriate. Okay.
Okay, and then the last question I have is, it's a little bit out of topic here. I saw you generate an email back to the user of the bot
mm-hmm.
by using some of the attribute collected along the way.
Yeah.
Right? Yes. Can I do that to send it to somebody outside of the user?
Absolutely, like, yeah. So yeah. It's a function. So you can go to a function. I mean, anywhere you can put in a function and then email from Juji. So right now we only support from Juji because we don't have access to your email. And then you can put the email address. Of course, you can put in the attribute from here. For example, here. And yeah, I mean, of them you can select from attributes.
So I can get anybody other than people that is in the Juji. You said you're limited to, you have to have a profile in the Juji system to send email to.
Oh no. So basically you just need an attribute. Depends on how you define the profile, but the attribute, if the attribute is there, you will be able to send the email. For example, this is a random user, but they give you the email, then you can send to them.
So my use case would be, let's say I need to escalate it to, let's say, to Michelle. So yeah. if it is a urgent escalation, I will SMS to her. If I am a normal escalation, mm-hmm. I will email to her.
Yeah.
I can use a function to do that.
Yes.
And
so
the body is full of attributes that I've collected to explain, you know, why I escalate.
Yeah. So yeah, so attributes are very powerful, especially if you have multiple actions. So mm-hmm. the SMS, I think we also support. Yeah. So basically, in your case, you will have a condition on, as you said, the
I'll do a condition on the in context flow.
Yeah, you can right? do that. Yeah.
And then in the in context flow, I would determine whether it's urgent or normal.
Right.
And then I appropriately in the post of the message in the in context flow, I will either, you know, call whatever function that I created.
Right, right.
You okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, no problem. So so let's continue then. Let's see. So we were I think I was just doing the similarity. So I've done with the similarity. Let's see what else we can do with the custom response. So one thing we can do is to have contains. This is useful if you are looking for a specific keyword. For example, I put in garlic. And as I mentioned before, we actually support have a trigger with multiple conditions. So you can add in all those combination of the same group. So here, I just want to add a sentiment. Only the positive one I care. And let's try something. Let's see what I'm gonna try. Say that. Okay, so let's try it then. So again, since we have multiple conditions, only if both conditions are met, the trigger will be triggered. Otherwise, if only one of them is true, the trigger will not happen. So let's say something like, I really don't like. Okay, see, this is a default response, so it doesn't trigger. But let's see, say, well, I really like olive. Oh, so it triggers since it's positive sentiment, also has dark king side. So what else we can do? So we can add default inputs. So we have a couple cases default inputs happen. So let's do something, let's say, okay. I don't know what the user input is, but I imagine reading that. So we do have a user response that triggers default, but the default is the building one, which is very generic. Let's try that again. See, now we change the default, we customize it. So when none of the trigger or previewed conditions matches, it will give you the default. And what's the last one? Last one is the is answered. So let's say if the question is answered, we wanted to do a extend reply. And there's two actions we can do. So one is to create new remark and add existing. Let's create a new one first. So you see the power of the extend reply is that you can choose different cards as answers. So instead of just plain text, I want the web media to show some pictures. So for example, I'm gonna show some picture of food. Give a link. Here. Okay. And let's see what happens. Okay, so I'm gonna say again, my favorite is this one. Okay, here's my food bookie. So because most times I can see the answer, but if you're, for example, if you have this, you skip this, say, is not required. Oh, did I say I can skip? Yeah, I have to turn this back on because I need to handle the skipping. So let's see what happens. Yeah, this doesn't work because we are actually inside preview. So there is some limitation on the preview because your preview actually, what it does, preview actually persists your states across multiple tries. So I have to try in the deployment. Yeah. So here I should deploy it. So. Something this skip actually might happen because our favorite topic actually captures the skip. Okay, so we will review this later on. So let's see what else we want to check is to have a say, repeat a current topic. So let's say, so the user have some in context question. And in this case, we will give some explanation why we ask about this and repeat the current topic. So for example, so what's your favorite food? And if I say, why do you ask? See, so he firstly acknowledges and then gives an explanation and we ask the question. This is also very useful when you combine with, say, some variations. For example, you can put, so, and what we ask. So now you have a variation for we ask. So it will not say exactly the same question wording as the first time. So one. See, so now use the we asking. So now make the chatbot more empathetic. And yeah, also we want to show you the fallback, right? So I'm gonna just change this one. I wanna add an action with like garlic. I will add a follow-up request and instead of creating a new one here, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna have my own topic first. And say how. So, and what happened is, I already have this, so I'm gonna add this, add this attached to it as the fallback, follow up. So I need to, okay. So I have this attached to this condition here, the trigger, and try again. What was I really last? Okay. Okay, so how do you like the document ginger? So it triggers our follow-up request. So let's say sometimes you want to say jump to a different topic when some condition happens. So if the user is a seafood lover, I will, instead of asking them if they have any questions, I will just jump to say directly to ask for their roles. Okay, so this. Like, what was that? Fish? Like fish. Oh, and I got it. Okay, so it jumps to the, skip a couple topics and jump to this topic about what your role is. And last but not least, you sometimes want to end the chat if something happens. So let's add a new one. If the user acknowledges it is AI, maybe that's the case, you don't want to chat with it anymore. So what I can do is just simply end the chat. Acknowledgement. And you can optionally give a URL in the end of chat. Okay, so ending the chat actually cannot, it's also something you cannot check inside the preview. So you will have to go to the deployment, the updating my deployment. Wait, we don't copy. Copy. Okay, so I say, what was it? Join us. So it triggers the response. It should redirect. Take a couple moments. Okay, so redirect to the page you selected. And that concludes our demo. And I'm gonna show you some resources. Let's see. Okay, here we go. Yeah, and you can reach us through support or our forum, and all our documentation is here, and you can see we have a lot of tips on how you design your chatbot. And yeah,
also included in the chat the webinar collection for our upcoming webinars. You can also access recordings of previous webinars and the YouTube channel for Juji as well.
Okay, yeah, is there any questions?
Yeah, just one last question, right? How about triggering a response based upon personality and some attribute?